The following presentation is brought to you by Discovery Education, leading the world of digital and video learning. Discovery Education, connect to a world of learning.
If you like helping animals and solving problems too, come and be mathematical and join the number crew. Join Fizz and Flo and Bradley and Ted and Mirabelle. And there's Baby Bunting who likes to help as well. So come and be mathematical and join the number crew. All aboard when you hear us call, the number crew needs you.
Why, heck, it's a scorcher today.
Yes, it is. There's too much sun.
Don't worry. I'm sure the kids are looking after themselves and the passengers. Staying in the shade. Wearing their sun hats. And putting on plenty of sun cream.
But you've forgotten one thing, Ted.
What's that, my love?
Is everyone drinking plenty of water?
Mirabelle's right, of course. Oh. When the weather's hot like this, it's very important you make sure you keep drinking plenty of water. Whew. Well, Mirabelle knows that, we know that, and so do the rest of the number crew. But do the passengers know it?
It's no good, Mum. We just can't get the passengers to drink enough water.
You can take a moose some water, but you can't make him drink.
Somehow we've got to make drinking water seem fun.
Well, here's a different sort of problem for the number crew to solve. Just how do you make water seem fun to drink? What do you think they'll come up with?
We could hypnotize the passengers. You want a drink of water.
I know what the problem is. These jugs are so boring. Let's make some really interesting things to drink out of.
Yeah, let's do it.
Yeah, right. Good idea. Make the thing the water's in, the container, the interesting bit. See if they can get the passengers to drink that way. Let's see how they're getting on.
Roll up, a lovely tall container. Perfect for the taller passenger. Come and get it. It's wide and low. That's the way to go for the shorter passenger.
All the rest of you, if you're not tall or short, try this beautiful container.
The tall, thin container?
The low, wide container?
Or the medium-sized container? Will the passengers come and drink?
Drink, 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 drink. Come try some lovely drink. You may not like water, but really you oughta. It's lovelier than you think. Come try this container, no need to complain, as it's big and it's tall and it's high. Come on, get your trunk in, yes, give it a dunk in. This container is elephant-sized. Drink, 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 drink. Come try some lovely drink. You may not like water, but really you oughta. It's lovelier than you think. It's lower and wider, it's just the right size. A container that's got what it takes. Come on, dip your lip in, it's time you were sipping. It's perfect for turtles and snakes. Try some lovely drink. You may not like water, but really you ought water, it's lovelier than you'd think. If you're not tall or small, this container's for all you creatures of medium size. Come on, put your muzzle in, it's time you were guzzling as you drink this container dry.
Well, water does seem to be more attractive when you've got something a little bit different to drink it out of. But I wonder which container held the most water. Bradley's tall one, Fizz's low one, or Flo's medium-sized one?
Well, it's obvious, isn't it? Mine's the tallest, so mine must hold the most water.
Are you sure?
I wonder if there's some way we could check.
Well, how could they tell which container held the most? Which of these containers do you think holds the most water? This is full up to the top, remember? So here we go. Do you think it will fill the other container up to the top? Or do you think the water will spill over? Only one way to find out. Hey, look at that. You see, it fills it right up to the top. So although these two containers are completely different shapes, they actually hold exactly the same amount of water.
Okay, I filled mine up again. Let's see what happens if I pour it into yours. Mind we don't spill any. Last drop coming out.
It's exactly the same.
That's amazing. I thought mine must have held more.
Try mine now.
It'll be really hard to pour the water out of this one. We'll spill it.
We'll have to find another way of getting the water from here into there.
Well, another little problem for the number crew to solve. How do you get the water from this container into that one without spilling it? Like this. One jugful at a time.
Here we go.
I'll count how many jugfuls. One. Two. Three. Four.
Jugful after jugful went into Flo's container.
18. 19. Last one coming up. Here we go. 20.
The containers all hold the same.
20 jugs full.
Now, something for you to look at here. Got a carton of drink and some cups. So how many cups do you think I'll be able to fill up with this carton? Have a look at the carton, have a look at the glasses. Make your best guess. That's two so far. Do you think we'll get any more? There you go. That's three. Almost done. Do you reckon I'll get any more out of this? There's a little more left in there. And looks like it's going to be about four. Yeah. Roughly four. There you go. Did you get it roughly right? Well done if you did. What? I don't think I'll drink this just now. I've been drinking plenty already today. Which reminds me, I've just got to go. I'll see you soon. Bye.
If you like helping animals and solving problems too, come and be mathematical and join the number crew. Join Fizz and Flo and Bradley and Ted and Mirabelle. And there's Baby Bunting who likes to help as well. So come and be mathematical and join the number crew. All aboard when you hear us call, the number crew needs you.